Cuts is a question-based system. We ask questions with stroking, nurturing, and empathy. We use a lot of redirection, like we did in the role play with Sergio before. Well, gee, you're working with that company for 15 years. Why do you don't really want to change, do you? They're a good company. No, they're not, because, and you force people to justify their decisions by using that redirection. You start, so we're a question-based system, three simple steps, agenda. At some point you want to set, this is the way I can help you solve your problem. Okay, so can I just ask you two, three questions? I'm not going to give you a formal presentation. I just need a little bit more information. I'm going to make you an offer. I'm going to offer you some solutions on your problem, and maybe we can do business together. And if we can't, would you do me a favor and fire me? It's okay to say no to me. That's an agenda. That's the agenda step. Okay. Draw a roadmap for them. Ask questions with redirections. It's okay for both of us. Just say yes or no. Gain their trust. Please fire me. What we're trying to do is create an adult to adult conversation. You guys can still see my screen. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Good. Good. Ever meet a sales? Have you ever met a salesperson who told you to say no? Why is that such an initial, such an important step up front? Why do we tell a prospect, fire me, don't have to think about it, just tell me to get lost? Why is that so important?
Don't waste any time.
You're not going to beat them to death.
What do you think's going on in their head when you tell them, look, I'm here for you, I want to help you, but if it's not right, it's not within your budget timeframe, what your needs are, you don't like my haircut, we can say it's over. Why is that so different from everyone else? Why do we do that?
Respect people's time. Pattern interrupt.
Right. What else? Go deep though. We respect.
Nobody else says it.
Yeah, but why? What's the why here? Go deep, guys.
You're getting them to lower their barriers by being able to fire you and just tell you no.
You think you're relaxing them? Oh God, I don't have a high pressure dudette here. I don't have a high pressure person. This person sounds like they actually care or are interested, and they're not pressuring me. Does that relax the environment completely?
Yes.
Absolutely. Let's move on here. So that's your agenda step. Qualification. Screen okay?
Yes.
Okay. We need to find out. Most important one. I shouldn't have it down here. It should be up here front. What happens if they don't have the money, the credit, or the finances to buy your widget, your real estate, whatever? If they don't have it, is it over?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
So if you find out upfront that they don't have money, credit, financing, support, co-signer, whatever you're looking for, it's not in their budget. How much time should you spend with this person?
Under 3 minutes.
Are we allowed, this is going to be tough for you guys, are we allowed to fire the prospect if they do not meet with our needs?
Yes.
Yes.
Say it like you mean it, guys.
Yeah.
Yes.
The salesman has rights.
We have rights. Thank you, David. We have rights in the sales process. We have to discover their needs, their greeds, their problems, their pains. We have to qualify what's their emotional EQ, their emotional quotient. What is their behavior? What is their passion? We do that by asking questions, maybe telling stories, by getting them, asking them redirection. Once again, gee, I don't understand. Why do you want to sell a house? You've been in it 15 years, stay in it another 15. We got to give them a score or a rating, okay? If we can't get them over a 4 or 5 and we've spoken to them for 15, 20, 30 minutes or more, are we going to close that person?
No.
No, get off the phone with them. You're wasting your time.
Can you give an example of how you would just cut them off and end it?
Dave, if I understand you correctly, you really don't want to sell your home until maybe next year sometime. Right now, the kid's got to finish school, and you don't really want to move until next January, February. Maybe we should, why don't we schedule about 30, 40 days before that? I'll call you around Thanksgiving and we'll focus on that, because it doesn't sound like you're ready to make that decision right now. Is that a fair assessment, Dave?
Actually, yes.
Okay. This is what I am going to do. It's been really nice to speak with you, meet your family. I'm going to send you guys a little gift. I'm going to send a video summarizing what we can do and how we can solve your problem. And you and I'm going to set up an appointment for November 5th on Zoom. And we're going to talk some more at that time when you're closer to being ready. Is that fair?
Totally.
I love doing business with you, sir. Thank you.
Boom. Thank you.
Yeah. Character matters. And then we go to the close. We're almost out of time here. We've got to get commitment, micro commitments. We've talked about that a couple of weeks ago. We got to move up the commitment to close. We've got to qualify them. And then we got that commitment. Once we get that commitment, we can satisfy their needs and greeds. Finally, with the presentation, this is where we, after we get the commitment, we've qualified them for money, time, decision, everything else. This is when now we present the intellectual properties of our features or, and benefits. Okay, this is the problem you have, Mr. and Mrs. Prospect. This is how we can solve the problem. This is how we can work it in your budget. Now you tell them about the horsepower, the little intellectual gobbledygook. You review, once again, keep it emotional. You review their needs, their fears, their joys, multiple times, needs and greeds. And then you make them buy by asking the question, Dave, this is your problem. This is how we can solve it. You told me if you found a solution, I think we have. I have made a decision that we're going to do business today. How do you feel about that? What would you like to do next? Are you ready to be a man and make this decision in the best interest of your company today?
Yes.
That's the question that you ask. And then you do the don't love and leave. You've got to do the post-sell step.